In this video, we'll see how to measure the choke coil parameters by using voltmeters and ammeters. So the name of the experiment is measurement of parameters of a choke coil using 3 voltmeter and 3 ammeter method. The components required for this experiment are 3 voltmeters, next choke coil, auto transformer, rheostat. Next, connecting wires. These are the required components. Now, as anyway we are doing experiment on the single phase, so we require the voltmeter up to 0 to 300 and the current drawn by this load is limited to up to 10 amperes, so you can take the range from 0 to 10 amperes. So, and rheostat, to vary the load current, we are using a rheostat, and here as we are using an inductive load, so this inductive load, as we are finding the parameters for this choke coil, so instead of choke coil we are taking an inductive load, so we are going to find the parameters of the choke coil. So now first I'll start with this 3 voltmeter method. So anyway, the same we are going to measure the parameters with the 3 ammeters also. First we'll start with the 3 voltmeter method. Now if you see the connection diagram for this 3 voltmeter method, the connection diagram is like this. First we have an auto transformer. So see the connection diagram. This is an auto transformer. Now from this auto transformer, first connect a voltmeter to measure how much voltage we are applying. Next, the ammeter to measure the current drawn by the load. As we are using a voltmeter here and variable rheostat to measure the voltage applied across this. Now, here another voltmeter across the load. Now, these are the connections for this 3 voltmeter method. So, 3 voltmeters, 1, 2, 3. Those are V1, V2, V3. And we have only one ammeter to measure the current drawn by the load. And if you see the tabular column for this, as we are using 3 voltmeters, we have voltmeter readings V1, V2, V3, and anyway we have one ammeter, that is ammeter reading I. So the remaining parameters we are going to derive by using a simple formulas. So those theoretical calculations are like this. Now V1 square is equal to V2 square plus V3 square plus 2 V2 V3 cos of the angle between V2 and V3. That cosine angle we can find like this: V1 square minus V2 square minus V3 square by 2 V2 V3. So anyway, as you know, this this value, V3 value is known. Next, I value is known, cos pi is known. Then we can find that P3, that is V3I cos pi. Next, you can find that P3 in other way. That is I square into that resistance value R3. So that resistance we need to find, that is R3 is equal to P3 by I square. As you know the relationship between this, V is equal to I into Z. So from that you can write Z is equal to V by I. So and Z3 you can find that impedance, that is R square plus X square. From that you can find that X value Z square minus R square. So once you know the XL reactance value, you can find L value, that is 2 pi FL, then L is equal to X by 2 pi F. Anyway, the standard frequency is 50 Hz, we'll take that F as 50 Hz. So now this is about this simple experiment, and now we will do how to conduct and how to find this V1, V2, V3 values and I step by step. So now coming to the connections, while doing the experiment, the connections are like this. This is an auto transformer. From this auto transformer, we are going to connect a voltmeter across this auto transformer. So now this is the first voltmeter V1. So anyway, here we are connecting this voltmeter across the supply. Next, here one more thing, to measure the current, we are using ammeter. So we will connect a common point of this voltmeter to ammeter. Next, the another end of the voltmeter is also there. Now this will be the second terminal. It is going to be connected to the neutral. So next, the second terminal of the ammeter is going to be connected to the next voltmeter. So you can see here, This is the next voltmeter and a common terminal for the rheostat as well as the voltmeter 2. So from that common terminal we are going to connect a second voltmeter V2, and in this anyway another terminal for the V is connected to be neutral point. Next here the another next the V3 voltmeter is going to be connected across this what we call across the load. Now this is a load terminal. Now across the load we are going to connect this V3 voltmeter. Now these are the three voltmeters, three ammeters and rheostat connections here. Now then how we are going to measure the values of this V1, V2, V3 and I will see in the experiment. We are going to apply a rated voltage through this voltmeter which is connected across the supply, that is V1 voltmeter. So I will set the voltage to 230 volts. So yeah, this is 115. As I connected to 300, so the multiplication factor is 2. 115 into 2, that is 230 volts. Next here the ammeter reading. So as we are not applying any we are not applied any load so far, so the ammeter reading is 0 and the voltmeter reading V, this is a voltmeter reading. And next here we have another voltmeter which is going to be connected across the load terminals. So now while varying the load we can see the deflection in this voltmeter, because which it is connected in series with the load. So that means here V2 is connected across the resistive variable resistive load. So that's why I have taken this V2 as a variable. V2 is used to know the variable voltage across the load. So here I will switch on the load. So when you switch on the load, earlier it is at a zero position, now you can find the deflection in the ammeter. Now I will slowly vary the inductive load. So slowly vary the inductive load. Yeah. Now you can see that deflection. So I will take the deflection at 0.4. So I have taken the range from 0 to 2 because it's anyway inductive current, inductive draws a small amount of current. So I connected at the 2 amperes and here is 0.4. The multiplication factor is, the range is 1 to 2 ampere ammeter, so multiplication factor is 2. So the ammeter reading 0.4 into 2, that is the ammeter reading. And anyway V1 is taken as 115, actually 115 into 2 130, but after applying this load there is a small change in that reading. That means 1 volt is reduced, around 2 volts is reduced. Now the first V1 reading is 228, not 230, now 228. Now coming to the V2, so the V2 is 70. Now I just connected to 150, so no need to take the multiplication factor. This is 75 volts, V2 reading. And this is a V3 reading. As I have taken this V3 at 300, the multiplication factor is 101. Into 2, 101 into 2, that is V2 reading. So this is the first one. Next again I will vary this, then you can see the deflection in the ammeter. Yeah, now it is 0.5. so the ammeter reading is 0.5 into 2, and again you can see the inductive load anyway it provides a voltage drop. So the V1 drop is, now you can observe clearly, that is 114, and ammeter reading anyway that is 0.5 into 2. Then the voltmeter V2 reading, there is no multiplication factor for V2, so this is 95 to 94, it is fluctuating 95. And the V3 reading is that is 92 multiplied by 2. V3 reading is 92 multiplied by 2. That's V2 reading. Again, I will vary this reading. So, again, I will vary the handle. Yeah, now it is current is 0.6 into 2, and V1 reading, again there is a small fluctuation in that, again that is nearly 114 into 2. Next, the V2 reading, now it is changed, so that is 110, around 113, that's it. There is no multiplication factor for V2. Next, coming to the V3. V3 is 92 into 2. That is V3 value. Now, if you want, you can repeat this procedure for step by step up to the range up to 0 to 5 amperes. Now we can repeat this procedure. The same thing is there for ammeters also. Instead of 3 voltmeters, we'll take the 3 ammeters to measure the choke coil parameters by using ammeter method. So, thank you.